We start today with Bilal Khan, who has been a frontline worker in the people's movements, starting with Narmada Bachao Andolan and throughout India with the National Alliance of People's Movements. Since 2014, Bilal has focused on the Ghar Bachao Ghar Banao Andolan, working with more than 100,000 people in 20 bastis across Mumbai. He studied political science in Delhi University, has a master's degree from IGNU, and was part of a program in peace and leadership in Switzerland. He is 29 years old. Since the lockdown began, he and his team have responded to calls from all over the city and outlying areas. They've not only delivered relief to hundreds of people every day with attention to special needs, but have also absorbed their stories with compassion and camaraderie. He is just back from another day of distributing, and we are honored to have him share his experiences with us today.
Yes, so I'm saying ideally the government should have been, you know, planned it well before turning the entire country into lockdown. And as a result of such an unprepared action, we have seen, all of us have seen videos and visuals where lakhs of migrant workers are on the street walking all the way to their homes, covering thousands of kilometers. In Bombay, we also having a very bad situation, is very bad. The migrant workers, we have so far covered in 23 days. Today is the 26th day of the lockdown, and we have covered till 11th of April. We have not got the update till today, but till 11th of April, we have covered 34,000 people, which comprise of groups like HIV positive, widowed women, women who have been divorced, domestic workers, migrant workers, daily wage earners. We are supplying them with daily dry ration and also nutrient foods to people with special dietary need. The response has been from the government. I'm sorry, I'm just very distracted. I've just come from the distribution drive. So let me start with the government came up with their relief package only after the lockdown was done. After 2 days, the government came with their relief package of 1.7 lakh crore, in which they tried to portray that they will be taking care of all the marginalized and vulnerable group. So they announced a free ration scheme. They announced free fuel scheme. They also some cash transfer to construction workers. But we have seen that firstly, there are a lot of gaps and loopholes in those packages. And secondly, those packages, even after 26 days of lockdown has passed, have not been implemented till today. For example, the free ration kit scheme covered either rice or dal or whole wheat. Apart from the regular entitlement under the PDS system to priority ration card holder. Priority ration card holders are those people who have annual income of 59,000 rupees in urban areas. In a city like Bombay, where people earn 15 to 20,000 a month on an average, won't be covered under this scheme. And under the PDS scheme, you only get rice and whole wheat. That's the only two grains that you get under the PDS system, which is inadequate in order to make a basic meal. Which basic meal required masala, oil, fuel, sugar, salt, tea. This is what you need on a daily basis in order to have a, you know, full two square full meal. But this is what government was offering under the free ration scheme, and which is inadequate, and that's why we decided to cover all these things to remaining essential item in our relief material kit. This is happening at a time when all the daily wage earners and migrant workers have lost their livelihood, and in a time like this, if we are expecting from those people who have lost all their livelihood and who have lost all their meager saving to spend on the remaining essential item like masala, cooking oil and fuel. Even after the first phase of the lockdown has passed, government has not learned any message, any lesson from the mistake it has done. They are continuing with whatever they scheme they with all the loopholes that that were there in their schemes, and it's very very difficult. So far the government has not reached out to the far off places in areas which are very you know, in the interior of the in the interior. So and then we, during our relief work, we have found out that there are a number of people, there are a number of groups which are there with the special dietary need, like HIV positive, who need to keep who need a nutritious and you know a kind of meal, a kind of food which will help them keep their immunity. So are the cancer patients, so are the pregnant women, so are lactating mothers, so are groups will areas where malnourishment is rampant. So those groups have been ignored in the planning and of this lockdown. So what we think is that the hunger response and the public health response, you see, on one hand you're trying to contain the virus so that it doesn't kill people, but in your efforts are such that your unplanned efforts are such that it is pushing people on death out because of hunger. So the hunger response and the public health response, the health response should have been integrated in their lockdown plan. meaning they should have been prepared to take, since we have only alone a migrant worker from West Bengal, are 1.45 lakh are the number of migrant workers from West Bengal, and government was offering was supposed to do some cash transfer to these migrant workers, but none of them have got any cash transfer. There are migrant workers more than you see. So the ration is not available. Free ration is not available. More than almost a month has passed. People are, you know, their fuel is getting over, and they don't have money to buy new cylinders. Kerosene was stopped long ago, and people have also sold out all their stoves, which they used to use their kerosene as a fuel. Now, and there are a group of migrant workers who have never cooked in their house. They would live in karkhanas and would eat in nearby dhabas. And now, without money, without any help from the government, they are on the verge of hunger. Just yesterday only, I was approached by a group of migrant workers from Mantop Hill. They were telling me that they were surviving on their meager saving which they had all these 20 or 25 days, but now they have no money, they have no supply from the government, and they are on the verge of you know, they are hungry. So luckily we could reach out to those people. Luckily we could also reach out to a group of migrant workers who have ran out of gas, and they did not have any gas connection, and they were forced to buy from the black market at a very high rate. And we had a friend nearby who went there and gave them some money so that they can buy fuel. So every household, every locality has some kind of difficulty or difficult story, or miserable story, which tells us that the government, in the first case of corona was found in January in India, and our government is very, very proactive in copying the model of the other countries. But before doing that, they were supposed to, they must have imagined what kind of crisis will unfold if they turn the entire country into lockdown. They should have taken all the migrant workers back to their native places. They should have ensured that they have all the supplies until the lockdown is there, and even after the lockdown is, we also have to think about what is going to happen after the lockdown is lifted, because a large number of people, migrant workers, have gone back to their villages, and a large number still are stuck in the in urban areas, and all the small scale industries shut. And in order to restart those units, industrial units, small scale industry, you need some capital, which is now lost. So we have to imagine a scale where the informal sector will be completely destroyed, and we will have to think of how to get employment and jobs to all those people who have lost their livelihood because of this lockdown. So government must have thought about it, and it's still not late. If they want, they can cover up. They should the entire especially the migrant workers, the daily wage earner who have lost their livelihood, they should be given regular supplies of food and other essential medicines, and special dietary requirements should also be taken care of until the lockdown, and even after the lockdown for a period, until the period then when they find some suitable and decent job so that they can continue with their they are able to find a livelihood. That is that can be one response immediate, that has to be immediate demand, and that has to be immediate response. And the environment should be such that the lockdown should not be forced, should not be a coercive action. People must be it is happening in containment areas in Bombay. Over 400 containment areas there in Bombay, and those containment areas are so strictly entry in those areas and movement in those containment areas so strictly prohibited that even you can't supply them the essential things, food and other medicine. We tried to reach out to those people. We could do it in the beginning when the containment was not strictly followed, but now if you want to reach out, like for example in Dharavi, it's one of the containment zone, and if you want to go there, supply relief material, it's not possible. We have to call people out, hiding, taking, they have to manage somehow to come out of their that area and get the supplies. So this is how difficult it is getting for the most poor in the containment areas. People they are running out of all the essential supplies, and government is like just today we were able to get we were able to get water supply in a settlement which was there since 20, it's a 20 year old settlement without water supply, and but they were managing somehow through the nearby buildings. They were getting the water supply from the nearby building because all the women, majority of the women who are living in this settlement, were engaged as domestic helps in the nearby building, and they would get all the potable water from those buildings. But as soon as the lockdown was announced, their entry was shut, and so the entry was shut, and so was the water supply. And they for a few days, for in the beginning, for a few of the lockdown, they had to rely on the drank the saline water, salty water, which they would use for washing clothes and cleaning their dishes. And after an invention, we were able to get them water supply from the municipal corporation. But today, because in the this settlement is in Andheri, which is marked as a red zone in Bombay, one of the many red zone in Bombay, they were harassed by the police. They were not allowed to collect water from those water tankers. So you imagine what kind of what is the behavior and attitude towards most poor people who were living with meager resources in this lockdown, and the water supply which we could manage with so much difficulty were and now being harassed to collect water. So crisis is very nobody can gauge the scale of crisis which is on right now in the entire country and all over the world, and poor are facing the brunt of this lockdown, unplanned, especially in India, unplanned lockdown. But it's still time. There's still time. Government can cover up. Government can still take those who are stuck in Bombay or in other major urban centers to their native places and ensure that they have all the basic necessities and food supplies, and also give them some support so that they can find some work after the lockdown is lifted, it's over. And also on the if you compare India with other countries, it's being said that, you know, we are doing well on the front of containment of the virus, but there are interpretation that, you know, the testing is not done on that scale which ideally it should have happened.
Thank you so much, Bilal. After a long day of distributing, you spared some time to talk with us, so we really appreciate that. And you know, the testing is also, you know, inadequate here in the US as well, so we're really hoping that things don't go the same way in India as they have here.